Blackstone Audio presents Nakamura Reality by Alex Austin. This book is read by Feodor Chin. This book is dedicated to my agent, Claire Anderson Wheeler. Prologue, Oceanside, California. Hugh Mcpherson glanced at his watch. 30 minutes. The waves weren't getting any smaller. Slabs of water, rhinos, the surfers called them, which didn't stop dozens of thrill-seekers in black wetsuits from stepping into their path. Kneeling on the sand, a short distance from Hugh, his sons, Takumi and Hitoshi, gazed mutely at the scene. Although there were surfers not much older or taller than the twins, none were quite as young as 11. None with their slender builds, none with their narrow shoulders. If Setsuko had seen the surf, she wouldn't have considered letting their sons go in. But his wife had remained at their Oceanside timeshare condo, feeling ill, attributing it to the takeout dinner they ate on the 2-hour drive down from their Studio City home, where their suitcases were packed to take their real vacation, a month of summer at her father's house in Tokyo. A month of rain and humidity. After Setsuko made known that she wasn't going to the beach, Hugh made the phone call and then showered. Leaning back on his beach towel, Hugh scanned the path of a seasoned surfer as he soared down the steep front of his wave, cutting white tracks, sending up sparkling jets. For such big surf, the water was beautiful, light green and transparent. A bright, warm day under baby blue skies. Hugh pried the lid off his coffee and sipped the flavorless 7-Eleven brew. "They aren't that big," said Takumi, 5 minutes older than his twin and the more assertive of the two.
"What if we stay close to shore, Dad?" asked Hitoshi. "Just catch the wash," added Takumi.
"Let's just wait," Hugh responded. Hugh drew out a box of donuts from his gym bag, opened it, and offered the jelly-filled cakes to his sons. Hitoshi took one, but Takumi declined. As Hugh chose one for himself, a seagull swooped down and settled a few yards away. Hugh closed the box, set it on the blanket, and bit into his cake.
"Not like we're swimming. We've got the boards," insisted Takumi.
Hitoshi clapped his brother's shoulder.
"We'll stay close together."
"We've surfed bigger waves at Topanga," added Takumi.
"Way crazier than this," said Hitoshi.
I know, Hugh admitted.
"What's so special about today, then?" asked Takumi.
Yes, what was so special?
A cadre of surfers soared down a wave slope like rocket streamers.
"Nothing," snapped Hugh.
"Why did we come here, then?" asked Hitoshi. "You're always telling us how good we are," said Takumi.
"You are good," Hugh said with conviction.
"Then why can't we go?"
Hugh set down his half-eaten donut on the box and pointed.
"Look at the size of that wave."
"We wouldn't take that wave. We're not stupid."
"Of course not, but it's not just one wave."
Feeling a flutter of air, Hugh twisted to see the gull, Hugh's half-eaten donut in its beak, taking off.
"Hey," said Hugh, reaching for the bird but catching only air.
Sighing, he shoved the donut box in his gym bag. The boys seemed not to have noticed the theft.
"We'll stay close together."
"Let's give it time," said Hugh.
Groaning in disapproval, they worked their torsos out of their wetsuits, revealing the smooth, fair skin, identical down to the freckles on their shoulders.
20 minutes.
Sipping his coffee, Hugh leaned into his sons, thinking he would hear their whispers of consolation, but they were silent, staring at different horizons. His head felt heavy, feverish. He closed his eyes for a moment, hoping to slip an oncoming headache. The clap of a wave breaking close to shore sounded sharply like a gunshot, taking away his breath. He swallowed, drove his hand through his hair, and laughed stupidly.
"Relax, relax."
Hugh squeezed Takumi's shoulder.
"How do cheesesteak sandwiches sound when we get home?" he asked. Even the mention of food.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.